archaeological record indicates that Karakol was settled by 600 BC. The written history for the site begins much later. Retrospective hieroglyph texts on two late classic monuments note that the site's dynasty originated in either 331 or 349 AD. The progenitor of the dynasty was known as Kekayab Chak, and he was followed by at least 28 additional rulers.
Okay, this must have been some kind of living quarters, kitchen, or something.
What burgers down there?
Mayan burgers. The famous Mayan burger. When the archaeologists found this ruin, this is what the state it was in. They excavated out the ruin, and what you saw was the excavation. This is the jungle of Belize. Stella. I'm guessing it's a monkey or a lion. No, lion here, monkey here. Welcome into my tomb. What? Oh, it's going to be safe like that. Yeah, that's the building method they use. Where are you going, girl?
Okay.
Into a cave? This is the Rio Frio Cave in Belize. Belize is known to have the most number of caves in the world. The fact that a lot of the rivers are underground. Here we go. Next adventure. Come on, smile. Hello, good morning. Black Rock.
Hey guys.
Hello.
The Mayans were an ancient civilization who lived on the Yucatan Peninsula in northeastern Mexico over 1,000 years ago. And like all primitive people, they were very superstitious. They felt they had to appease the gods and offer them sacrifices in return for favorable war conditions, adequate rainfall to refill their drinking wells, and most importantly, a bountiful crop harvest. They had sacred cenotes that they would use to throw young females down who were virgins. And of course they would drown, having been drugged and bound beforehand. The cenote walls were very steep, and the cenote itself was over 40 feet deep. It was impossible to escape. So this is the story of the first Mayan blues man who lost his girl like this. He was pretty upset about it, but there was nothing he could do though, as it was his people's custom. So he wrote a song about this tragedy. It was the only way he could console himself. So here's the story.
Well, they took my baby and threw it down a sacred well. Yes, they took my baby and threw it down a sacred well. And she has never come up far as I can tell.
6 centimeters big. The soldiers, like a 1 centimeter big, the laborers, a little bit smaller. And then they have what we call the hitchhikers. The hitchhikers are the ones who keep the balance between the leaf and the ant.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Try to take them out. Come on, there is one.
There is a soldier.
Yeah.
Look at there.
Oh my God, they're huge.
Yeah. Come over here. That's the ant. You see the pinchers or the tweezers in the front? Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. That can rip your skin very easily. Mm. According to some people, the ancient Maya used these as a stitches when you have a wound.
Oh.
Okay, give you an example. Can I use your shirt?
Of course.
Right here. See? See how it grabs the,
oh, yeah,
the leaf? Okay, see how strong it is?
Yeah.
Wow.
So what they used to do is this, cut the head and leave it right there. So that will close your wound.
Okay, appreciate it.
Right?
Is this going?
Wow.
Yeah. See how many of them coming out?
Yeah, mm.
Those are the soldiers protecting the nest.
Ancient Mayan stitches.
Wow. It's for lunch.
Try one.
They try one?
Like carrots.
Ew.
Like woody carrots.
Yeah. Yep.
No, thanks.
You
no,
have
please.
A mosquito in your right cheek.
A light here.
No, thank you.
Come on.
They make the bugs separate.
First off, the guide should eat the carrots, or we should eat the termites first.
Yes. So they will go to a different place and start to dig again. But what we use here, guys, is the nest. When we are camping, okay, and there's no mosquito repellent, what we can do is just burn the nest. Give you a smelly smoke and keeps the mosquitoes away. Because it's very oily, all right? So you see the hole I opened this morning? It will be closed when we come back. They're very sensitive to light.
Oh.
The termites.
Yeah, I'm fine. I just thought you wanted to be the leader.
How you call them? Latex. The latex. Look at this.
Oh okay. My God, look at that.
Here, this is what the people collect in the past to export to United States. Rubber tree, okay? The latex. And also the ancient Maya used to collect this to build the ball for play the ball game, the Poutapoc. All right? That they play in representation of the sun movements from east to west.
What was it called?
Poutapoc.
I couldn't.
Poutapoc. It's very, a little bit hollow. Sounds hollow, but it's not really hollow inside. It's because it's latex in there, all right?
Yeah.
Rubber tree or Castilla Elastica. They use for model airplanes.
Yeah, I use that for general travel.
Because you need to have a PhD to say I discovered this. But in the 1800s, the Spaniards and the British were here. They left documents about these caves. It's about 12 caves in total. In 1986, Dr. Miller found out these papers and he read about it, and he hired a local guide from Tiquetel Village. The first time they came in was following upstream, right? And 1986, so he invited some spelunkers from England, from Queen's Mary London College. And they mapped the entire cave, which is 3.3 miles in length, or 5.3 kilometers. After they mapped the entire cave, they report the cave to archaeology department, which was 1989. So you will find in National Geographic magazine sometimes that it was discovered 1989, but it's not true. It was 1986. 89, they reported to archaeology department. 1991, few archaeologists came here, okay, just to do observation of the cave. But they did not start any research at that time. 1993, Dr. Jaime Awe came with National Geographic Television to film the cave, and they called the film Journey to the Underworld. 1995, Dr. Awe came back with a few cave archaeologists, okay, or speleoarchaeologists, to start a research in that cave, but wasn't much. It was until 1996 when they officially got the permission from archaeology department to start the research. It's when they built these little touch houses here, or what we call campsite. Sorry. Where is those people having lunch right now? That was the laboratory right there, okay? Kitchen is next touch house there. This was part of the dining room, sleeping area down there, and also back there, okay? 1996 to the 2000, they spent 6 months every year, from January to June, July. And they have a few tents also around there. 1996 to the 2000, they discovered 14 human remains, okay, in the Maya levels or the dry chamber, and a burial in the entrance. 1,500 pieces of pots of ceramic, obsidian blade, which is the volcanic rock, stone tools made of granite, ocarinas. Do you know what's an ocarina? Ocarina is a musical instrument, small ones, like a play has a flute or whistles. And also they found a jaguar pelvis, okay, which is only the pelvis, which is surprising for the archaeologists. Well, why only the pelvis, okay? So Dr. Awe suggests that the ancient Maya start to use the entrance of the cave from 250 AD to 700-900 AD. Early Classic, Late Classic, Terminal Classic period, okay? They use the cave as a source of water, human sacrifice, food offerings, right? And not everyone was allowed to get in there. Only rulers, elite, and shamans. The lower class people will be here doing their rituals, okay? How often they went in there, we do not know, okay? But archaeologists found out that the ancient Maya started to use caves in Belize at least 350 BC, yes. All right, not this cave, other caves. But when the ancient Maya started to use the caves a lot, was 700 to 900 AD, okay? For religion purposes. Rituals, human sacrifice, food offering, and has a source of water. Any question? No? Today, guys, we're gonna be talking about Maya religion, okay? Maya underworld. Probably in the surface sites, you heard different theories about the Maya, this Maya, that. But we're gonna be talking specifically about religion, what they were doing there, what they believe, okay? So if anytime you have any question, please feel free to ask, right? Once we get inside of the cave, I will recommend you to keep your helmet all the time, okay, on your head. Do not do like some people just, oh, it's too hot, and they start to walk, bam, they bounce their head in the limestone, all right? I will be pointing to you, rock to your left, rock to your right. I want you to pass information to the person behind. No by words, just point where is the rock, okay? Rock to your left, and make sure the person catch what you're saying. And also, I know I would like you, if any time you want to stop and take a look at stalactite, do it. But do not walk at the same time and look up because people get hurt that time.
Okay.
All right. Your cameras, you're going to take a picture of the entrance, sorry, and then we'll go to my dry bag. Okay. But I don't give you the camera every minute. I'll give you until we get to the dry chamber, and then you take any picture much you want.
No, not at all.
What do you think so far?
Very cool.
What's the coolest thing about it? The fish in the water?
Everything.
Or the tunnel?
Everything.
The tunnel of the...
That's classic.
Like in the TV, I see the kids when they hear any news or something, they're like...
Put it in.
Rimstone dams, rimstone pools, travertine dams, travertine pools. These are the dams, okay? Those are the pools. Do not walk inside of the pools, walk on the dams.
Okay.
Most of the artifacts are covered with calcite. Look at this. It's covered with calcite, and it's covering a rim of a pot like that over there, okay? This one here is what we call Manu and Metate. Manu and Metate is the grindstone and the handheld where it used to grind food and so on, all right? So remember, keep in mind, walk on the dams, not in the pools.
Okay.
Any question?
Crystal no? Clear.
Be careful with your back and shoulders going through there, all right?
Let's go.
Hi, Mama. I don't know if this cage is getting smaller and getting bigger. Oh my. Thank you. what you call site. Right? See the big one back there? There is some under the rock. Some up there. Look at that.
Wow, look at that.
Right? Most of these artifacts, guys, 700 to 900 AD, late classic period, okay? Food offering. Food offering. And we're walking through flowstone formation. This is what we call flowstone formation, means water was dripping here and cover the floor with calcite, okay? Most of the artifacts contain calcite because the water covered them, right? No? No? What is the day of death for you guys?
All Saints Day.
All Saints Day. What day celebrate at that time, today's days?
The day after Halloween, November 1st.
Day after Halloween, what they do, they go to the cemetery, they carry part of their food, okay, or whatever they offer to top of the tomb, or they bury it under the ground, okay? But they used to do that at night before, they do it during the day. What they believe is that somebody, their ancestral spirit will come and eat part of their food, okay? So maybe a dog pass by or a human pass and eat part of the food or drink the bottle of rum or the cigarette they offer. They happy with that because they believe in reincarnation, right? So that's something similar happened in the past. The ancient Maya believe if they don't feed the ancestors' souls, the ancestors will go out at night and haunt their souls. That is the reason why they came here and they did the food offering. Right? They brought the pots, the food, and the wood, and they cook it in here. They never use the flesh of the food. They use the steam that the food release, okay? That was for the gods of the underworld. So they believe in that way, the gods would be happy with them. All right? Any question? Look at you, just like my right there. Okay. Some columns, stalactites. Maybe 100, 200, we don't know exactly, but water was flowing through here and covered some of them. This is 700 to 800 AD, also food offering. And these pots made of clay, okay? According to the experts in pots, is coil. They made a coil, okay, and handmade. And they probably used the open kiln to fire the pots. The open kiln goes for 400 to 600 Celsius, all right? Food offering right here. Look, the stalagmite. You turn around and you look behind. Look at there. Sometimes, what kind of food do they offer to their gods or their ancestors? One of the main offerings they did was cacao, okay, or the chocolate, cocoa, corn. beans, squash, and a lot of stuff that they can find there in the jungle. They found here what we call hutes. Hutes are a snail that they grow in the rivers, okay? And these hutes, they use it for the food offering also. They found hundreds of those shells over here, all right? And farther in you go, you will see more artifacts, okay? More ceramic. Let's keep going. Remember, the stony grounds don't walk only food.
And cricket. Hello, here.
See copper, sulfur, and calcite together. Look it up there. Take a look in this one right here. Look at that.